Everyone, good afternoon to everyone. This is Shruti Anand, journalist at K12 News, and I'm very delighted today as I'm present with Mr. Sinjo Jolly Matthew. Hello, sir. Good morning. Welcome
good morning,
to
Shruti.
K12 Talks. How are you?
I'm good. How are you doing?
I'm doing perfectly fine. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
So, Sinjo Jolly Matthew, he's an entrepreneur, life coach, startup specialist, and educational consultant. And it's a pleasure to have you at K12 Talks. First of all, I would like to thank you on behalf of K12 News and the K12 community, that all the educationists, teachers, and the students have been a warrior in this pandemic situation. I want to know that how exactly, what have been the challenges and how have been you tackling up with the challenges?
Okay, before going ahead, I would like to thank K12 News for giving me this opportunity to be a part of the show. And I would like to thank all the teachers and trainers, you know, putting up their effort at this crisis level. All right. And yes, if you talk about the positive of online trainings these days, because we have seen most of the time online trainings in India, especially, you know, even parents or teachers, they were not that much into the preference level. If you talk about the positives, what I would say is, rise in blended learning, the first point which I would like to discuss. The second is new learning management systems come to the next level. Rise in collaborative work. Initially, when we are in schools, when we talk about offline trainings, what we do is, it's completely, yes, at some point of time, in some schools, some organizations, it's always a collaborative learning. But most of the time, it's like we are following a traditional pattern, a traditional training. Teacher is standing, you know, at the blackboard, and students are listening to it. They're taking notes and everything. But here, it's an equal interaction. If a teacher is doing something, student has to be completely involved in it to understand, because teacher is not with them. They are completely away from the teacher, and they have to give their complete concentration to understand the topics, the concepts, and the complete pattern of education, of, you know, whatever they are learning. Next is, I would like to say is, they have started giving equal respect to all the subjects. You know, something which is very much necessary, what we see in India, especially in the education system in India, we are only focusing on science and maths. We are not focusing on any other subjects other than science and math. We are not giving that much importance. But here, when students and teachers, they have to give their 100% to each and every subject, they have started giving the importance of different subjects. They have started understood the meaning of different subjects. And now it is time to, even for the education system, to make each and every student aware about each and every subject. It's not only about physics, chemistry, maths, or biology. It's about all the subjects that has to be taken care of. Yes, this is the positive aspect. And I would like to talk the negative aspect as well, because we were not expecting this kind of situation which arrived.
That was totally unpredictable, out of nowhere.
Unpredictable.
No one would have predicted this.
Yes, so the teachers were not that prepared to understand the online, the technology, you know, how to go ahead with this. Because if you talk about the metropolitan cities or the top short schools, they're okay with it. Teachers are well versed with it. But if you talk about, right now I'm in Kerala, if you talk about Kerala, you know, there are a lot of, you know, schools in villages. But the point is, teachers are not even aware how to use the technology. Most of the time I have seen teachers, they put their microphone on mute and they start talking. So that means they're not trained. So they haven't got that much time to understand the technology. They have not well trained to, you know, provide the classes, but they are giving their best, because they have to be well prepared before the classes, after the classes, for the next class. At the same time, they have to evaluate the students and parents, because it's not only students who is involved in online teaching, it's parents as well. So parents also, you know, they continuously call them at any point of time. It could be 6 p.m., it could be 9 p.m., even it could be 10 p.m. or late night. So teachers are very much, they have to be well trained, and they are getting trained in a, you know, day-to-day process. And this is one suggestion that, you know, education, each and every school should come up with something new, so that, you know, they get trained in every aspect, not only using the technology, how to go ahead with this.
Right. I totally agree with you on these pointers. There have been negative as well as positive impact of this pandemic situation. Moreover, the lockdown, the students not visiting the school, etc. But something positive too came out. Moving forward, what do you think that as a paradisian conversation, you wanted to share that why exactly there is a need of change in education system in India? Why do you feel so?
Okay, if we talk about, it's been a long time we are following the same traditional teaching. We are following the same pattern. We are following the same syllabus. Apart from India, if you talk about the Western countries, the European countries, we can see the education system that we have. I'm not saying that, you know, our education system is completely bad. We all are experienced into our education system. If I'm sitting here, if you're sitting here, it's only because of the education that we have received from our country. But it is the time right now, and it is a gap as well to understand, to analyze the education system that we have. Because, okay, it's fine. It's COVID-19. We understand the education system is completely going online. But this is a time to understand why do we need to change the education system that we have. First, we are completely into rote learning. Rote learning, hope you understand, is completely a repetition. What we have studied last year, studying same thing next year. So we need to change a lot of things. We are completely into theoretical learning. We are not into practical learning. And the evaluation system has to change. What is happening right now? Assessment is going on. Teachers are checking online. Teachers are checking papers. It's not necessary that, you know, they're checking each and every papers, each and every questions. Sometimes what happens is they just go, okay, fine. The answer is, if it's math, they'll see, okay, the answer is correct. It's gone. But the concept is correct. The formula that they have used, whether it is correct, it is not. Because evaluation system, apart from the theoretical thing, I think what I believe is it should come to a practical level. Totally. Then something which I've shared before, equal respect to all the subjects. Especially in India, we are not giving any equal respect to all the subjects. We're giving respect respect to each and every subject that we are studying every year. But if you talk about physics, math, bio, these are the subjects that, you know, even parents stress on. Is it that we only need doctors, scientists, and engineers? No. We need IAS officers. We need pilots. We need IPS officers. We need, you know, people to safeguard our borders. So there are a lot of options. So people are not, our education system is not focusing that much on, this is what I have felt. It's been 17 years I'm into this industry. This is what, even if you go for any kind of career guidance, we can see career guidance done by a lot of, you know, big shots training institute for medical and GE, IIT and GE. They give only career counseling for medical, to become a doctor or to become an engineer. Why not other fields? Even parents, they don't understand the importance of other verticals. So we should make them understand. We should add something. It should be a blended process in the education. We should add something which should come into the education system, wherein a student can understand their inborn talents and something, a talent which they can acquire from the inborn talent. It's not only that, you know, they have only the quality to become a doctor or an engineer. Someone can become a good artist. We need artists. So there are a lot of things. And yes, of course, the technology has to blend with the traditional teaching. Right now, we're using technology and we're using traditional teaching. So they're not still completely going together. Either it's traditional teaching or it's a technology. So we have to make it in a proper way where this technology and traditional teaching should come together. Okay. And we should focus on personalized education, which is happening, but it has to come to a different level. And we should understand each and every student and parents and teachers through education, the purpose of education. Because most of the youth, most of the students, they are not aware about the purpose of education. It's just they're studying. They're just going ahead with the pace. What do you want to become in future? Not decided. I'll complete my 12th exam and I'll decide. So they don't know the purpose of education. Most of them, they drop after 12th. They don't continue the education. They should understand the value of education. Why even teachers or parents, you know, insisting them to study. But even for that, parents as well as teachers should be educated. And that has to come into the education system.
Right, very well said. I do agree to it because these lately the students have not been that much involved in the studies. Usually they decide what they want to become in life after once they are done with their 12th. But as for now, this scenario is a bit changed as the majority of the students have moved toward this side. That they have no clue, they are just studying. They'll just log into the classes, they'll mute the button, they'll turn off the video chat. So what are the strategies and what could be the ways to keep them involved so that they don't miss out on studies? Because once the basics are missed out, one cannot perform the excels in studies. So what are your suggestions on that?
Okay, if you talk about how to make them engaged, we cannot blame students, parents or teachers that they're not focusing on what is happening, because they were only enjoying the tablets or the technology for games, Facebook and a lot of other social activities, but they were not that much trained to be a part of an online education. So what I feel is we have to set personal learning planning, a planner, so that it should come from the student side. It should not be from the trainer side. Okay, yes, I'm giving you this, you have to do this. That means the student voice, input from student has to be taken care of. We should make them a trainer along with the teacher. It should be each and every student, they should be a trainer. It should not that, they are listening, we can see a lot of students, on the screen. No, they should be the trainer along with the teacher. And yes, of course, parent involvement is very much necessary, because parents should understand the importance of online education. Still, there are a lot of areas in India, a lot of locations. I don't want to pinpoint any particular location. Parents still feel that online education is not good. Students are not focusing, because most of the places, if we can see, even I have seen a lot of videos wherein students are not in the picture. Parents and the grandparents are attending the online classes.
Right. So, there were many cases that came out.
Yes. So this is not the problem, coming from a child. It is not even a problem, coming from a parent. It is the lack of literacy about education or the online education. Why is it necessary? Yes, the situation right now is that, we are not in a condition to conduct physical classes. But we have to continue our education. We cannot stop it in between. We have to go ahead with this. So to complete that, because teachers are putting their maximum effort, because it's not that easy to conduct online classes from home. It's very difficult to take care of the family, take care of household things, take care of the kids, and to attend online classes. Even after classes, they have to prepare, they have to sit and prepare for the next day's class. So students, we should make them, it should be more interactive, rather than just, again, a traditional online teaching. We should engage them with, self-assessment. We should give them a lot of things to, assess, a self-assessment kind of thing. It's not that, teacher is giving a test and the student is writing the answer. Teacher is saying, okay, yes, right, no. There should be some sort of evaluation system where a student can assess themselves, a self-assessment. So that they also get a feeling, okay, yes, I have to do something. This is a part which, from my part, I have to complete. Apart from a teacher, I have to do something which is important. And of course, yes, more learning pathways. Still, we are focusing on the same thing. We are studying books. We are giving them formulas and concepts that we have studied in school. We should come with new learning pathways online, because it's a different technology we are using right now. That is online. Teachers at home, students at home. So we should come up with something different as well. If you are doing it in a different way, if online teaching is different, we haven't experienced, it's been almost, I think we all completed college and we all completed schools. We have never experienced something like this. So we have come up with something new. So I think more learning pathways should come into existence. We should come up with something new. The education system should change. So we need to think, because it's an ongoing process now. Even if we are back to schools, this online training is going to be, on its peak. It is going to be on a higher note, higher side. So we have to come up with a lot of things which is different.
Right. At some point or other, there are changes that are very much required, be it the education system or be it the whole country. After whole 5 years, the government has changed. So why not? There should be changes in the education
Absolutely
system.
Absolutely right.
Right.
Yes.
So I do agree with that point. So thank you so much, Sanjo, for your valuable time and giving
your
contribution
so
in this K-12 Talks 2020. We are really honored to have you here. Also, I've been thanking all the K-12 community, I would like to thank you as well. That all the educationists, the teachers, the principals, the students, they have been a warrior in this pandemic situation. So thanks a lot, and we are really grateful. Let's hope that the situation will turn out positive really soon, and we'll be all able to go out and enjoy the lives as they were earlier.
Yes, and I would like to take this opportunity to thank you again, K-12 News, and especially you. And I would like to wish each and every teacher, not only in India, across the globe, they're doing a tremendous job. And I wish them all success, and I hope that we can come up with something new which will engage students and parents to understand the skills and talents in each and every child, and so that they can go something which they want and they need. It's not that something from the parent side or the teacher side, become a doctor, become a engineer. No, there should be something which a student want. They have their own talent, they have their own skills. So let us hope for the best, and let us try to build up something new into the education system, wherein we can blend it with the traditional teaching as well as with the new technology that we are going ahead with. Thank you so much.
Right. Thank you. Thank you, viewers. This was Shruti Anand, present with Sanjo Jolly Matthew. And for more updates, stay updated, and we'll be right back with a few more educationists. Thank you so much.
Thank you.